Well, a number of former senators eyeing a comeback to the upper chamber. One of them is Deputy Speaker Antica Representative Lauren Legarda. She will be running under the Nationalist People's Coalition. Congresswoman Legarda now joins us on the program. Congresswoman, good afternoon to you and thanks for joining us today. Nice to see you again.
Good afternoon to you, Carmina, and to the whole ANC team. It's been a while. I hope everyone's safe and healthy. Congratulations on being a new mother. I just found out today. Anyway, hope everyone watching are safe and sound. Yes, ang daming pag-uusapan, ang daming dapat gawin. Diretso na ako sa pag-ahon, pag-ahon sa pandemya at hindi lang yun, pag-ahon din mula sa kahirapan at sa pagbibigay ng pangkabuhayan sa mga tao.
Yeah, so Congresswoman, I want to get to your decision. What made you decide to have another go at the Senate?
Thank you for that. I was in the Senate as a very young senator in 1998. I served 3 terms, proud and inspired to say that most, if not all, of the environmental laws and the laws on women, children, I either authored or sponsored. I have to make sure that these, especially now in the time of pandemic recovery, are implemented efficiently and effectively and funded and that everyone understands. Second, while I am so inspired and I've done, if I may say so myself, a great deal in just 2 years in Antique, I was able to bring national government programs, policies, and projects closer to the people that they have not had or felt or experienced in 3 decades, 30 years. I believe I have much, much more to share, to give both Antique as a province and the 80 provinces of our country, of the 108 million Filipinos I love dearly. And Carmina, in the 2 years I've been Congresswoman, not one person has called me Kong. Even in Antique, they call me Sen, Senator. And you should see the emails and the texts and all the help on Facebook in all parts of the country, including the Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao and in the Cordillera, in far-flung barangays, asking for help in the 1.5 years of the pandemic.
Yeah, but Congressman, let me just get this in edgewise. You had the front seat, as you said. You were closest to the people. From a national level, you became a representative of Antique. You were this close to the people, seeing the impact on their lives. Why exchange that for another go at the Senate? Isn't that the dream of a public servant, to really see how the policies that you enact really affect people's lives?
That's true. I've seen in my 2 years how the laws that I've authored in my 3 terms are actually applicable and benefit the people. I also see the need for a different kind of pandemic recovery. Kailangan natin iakma ang ating pag-ahon mula sa COVID-19 at sa iba pang mga mangyayaring pandemya ayon sa pagbabago ng klima na krisis. Let me say it in English. I sincerely believe that the pandemic recovery is not just a health issue, that it must also be an economic recovery of every Filipino household, that the pandemic recovery must be attuned to the climate pathway. And these were laws that either I authored or are pending in both houses of Congress as well. Sa aking pakikipanayam sa mga tao, ang aking alam, ang aking malawak na karanasan sa panunungkulan sa nasyonal at pati ngayon sa 2 taon sa lokal ay higit na makakatulong sa pag-ahon natin mula sa pandemic recovery. At if I may say, several months ago, I was invited to a virtual cabinet meeting where my views on health, on even vaccine rollout, and on many issues, including livelihood, were secured. And I'm so grateful that as a congressman of 300 more representatives, I was asked as a former senator in my term, my views were actually implemented, my suggestions. And I'm continue being urged by many of non-Antiquenos, but outside of my province, we need you now. Mm. Who am I to say no if there is such a calling, if I may? Because I said, I cannot leave my district. But then again, we see the bigger picture and bringing national government programs closer to the people at this time is so important. I will repeat, the pandemic recovery must be attuned, akma dapat, sa ating pag-attack sa problema ng kalikasan at sa pagbabago ng klima.
When you talk about the bigger picture, I want to focus now on what you just said, the environment and having a climate-proof future for the Philippines. Yes. You were one of those who were really out there way before it became popular, way before people started taking it up as their advocacy. But as your brief stint of Antique, as Antique governor, congresswoman, I should say, what were the disconnects? You've helped shape the country's policies when it comes to environment and climate proofing our future. But when you talk about your experience in Antique, were there any disconnects and gaps from national to yes. local? Go ahead.
Armina, hindi lamang sa Antique, kundi sa buong bansa, ay magagandang ating ibang mga nalahad na polisiya at mga batas. Una, may mga hindi napopondohang batas. Pangalawa, may mga hindi efficient or maayos ang pag-implement. At pangatlo, kailangan ng amendahan. At sabi ko, hindi lang ang pagprotekta ng ating kalusugan, kailangan economic recovery. For example, yung ginawa kong batas nung ako'y bata pang senador, yung PESO Law, Public Employment Service Office. Yan ay nasa batas, na amendahan na yan. Pero ito ay sa bawat probinsya at munisipyo. Sa tingin ko, ngayon, kailangan natin bigyan ng pangkabuhayan ang bawat barangay. Iakma natin ang mga natural resources at yung skills at talento at yung pangangailangan ng tao at yung rate of joblessness per barangay. 42,000 plus barangays. So, ako'y naggawa ng panukalang batas na Barangay Employment and Entrepreneurship Office para amendahan yung aking ginawa noong 1998 na ngayon ay biso. Isa lang yan sa maraming mga panukalang batas na tingin ko ay dapat ay karapat dapat at makakatulong para umahon ang mga household. Dahil ang ating macroeconomics din, tignan natin ang ating ekonomiya, huwag na tayong humiling na bumalik na sa dati dahil yung dati nga ang nakawasak ng ating buhay. Kailangan ang ating macroeconomics ma-mainstream ang resilience, ma-mainstream ang sustainable development, ma-mainstream ang climate emergency at crisis at dapat maintindihan, maramdaman ng bawat sektor ang epekto sa kanilang buhay anumang lugar sa ating archipelago.
Okay.
Mga tao. Yes.
But Congresswoman, when you look at reality, come 2022, it's going to be a crowded race. It's going to be a mixture of, you know, there are a lot of cabinet secretaries that want to have a go at the Senate. You have familiar faces. So tell us very briefly, why would the Senate need the same names? Why should there be a place for you still? You said it yourself. You've had three terms.
Yes. It may be the same names, but it's a situation the same now as before. Ang iyong alam, your expertise, your wisdom, your knowledge, and your experiences, will it serve the best interest of the Filipino people at this time? Do you have the competence? Do you have what it takes to be able to help in this pandemic recovery so that it is resilient, it is sustainable, it will provide resilient rural livelihoods, it will save the lives of our women and children and indigenous people and our senior citizens, it will resonate with the youth of our country. And that is what made me define my decision in consultation, of course, with lots of people from my district and all over the country.
Congressman, a while ago you said that you got invited to a cabinet meeting and they listened to your suggestions, they heard what you had to say, implemented some of your suggestions as well. The question now is, how divergent will your stand be from the current administration's policies and agenda? Because that seems to be one criticism that has been hurled against you, Congresswoman, that you have not really been critical of this administration when you should be, that you have kept silent when you have spoken up, Congresswoman. Okay.
You know, Carmina, by nature, I'm a builder, I'm a creator, and we only have 24 hours in a day. And the work I do locally, regionally, nationally, and globally does not even give me enough time to build and to comply with all these. Now, I define my policy. If I'm divergent from the others, I say so in a statement, in a press release, I speak about it. That is my way of conversing. I join the national discourse and I respect other people's opinions. Not everybody may think the way I do, just like I may not agree with some of the policies. And I say so calmly in the way I know how. And that's for people who know me, even when I debate in the Senate. I'm essentially a builder, and I believe that what we need in leadership now are people who can build, who can unify, who can heal. Kailangan natin ihilom ang mga sugat, hindi lamang sa politika, kundi na rin ang mga sugat ng pagsasamahan, sugat pa rin ng kalikasan, ng planeta, at kailangan natin pag-isa-isahin. Dahil kung hindi tayo sama-sama at walang unity, mahirap labanan ang kalaban na hindi natin nakikita. And I tell you, this pandemic will be more, just like the climate crisis, will be more intense, it will be more frequent, and as we see, there are different variants if we do not use science-based solutions. So as I said, there's so much to do, but for me to be very vocal and to about my views will entail a lot of energy, and my energy is focused on creating, building, and solving. It does not mean I will not speak my mind when I do not believe it is correct. I do. Maybe it's not seen on print or on digital all the time, but my statements will stand on record every day as my report card to the nation.
What do you say to those who still criticize you for being loyal to a president who has committed a lot of atrocities under his term? One of which, of course, is the closure of your home network. People still think of that day when they hear of your name. What do you say to those people?
Well, first of all, as you know, I'm one of the authors of the renewal of the franchise. And as you very well know as well, you saw my statement that at the time, I could not vote in favor. I had to abstain because I've ongoing programs on the network, on the station where you have. In fact, we just aired the result documentary, and I've ongoing programs at Dayaw. So it would not have been appropriate legally if I had voted in favor. So I believe that the network where I had glorious days of my life in the service of the Filipino must reapply for the franchise. I will help in any way, as I did behind the scenes, because I was not chairman of the committee. In terms of the voting, I adequately and sufficiently explained the legal reason why at the time I could not vote, because of the ongoing numerous airtime and programs that I was producing and involved with and hosting up to now with ANC. I wish I had cast the pang 13th or 14th vote. They know where my heart is, and it's been adequately explained for those who read my statement at the time.
Yesterday, we had your party mate, Governor Chis Escudero, on the show as well. He did confirm that he's also going to run for the Senate. And I asked him about the kind of leader that the country needs. You sort of touched on that a while ago. He did say, though, that the person has got to be a healing president. But my question for you, Congresswoman, is can healing begin without holding President Duterte accountable for the countless deaths, for the pandemic response?
Yes.
Go ahead.
First of all, I welcome Chis, and I'd be happy to have him back in the Senate. Pray God that we could be together there. Yes, correct, a healing president, a unifying leader. But I would like to see which of those who will actually run will have a sustainable development agenda for a resilient, healthy, green Philippines. I want to see all the laws that I authored and, let's say, the pending legislation on natural resource accounting mainstreamed in the agenda of the next leader. Whatever lacking in the leaders now and in the past. Yes, I am certain that there are the mechanisms, both legal and political, both national and global, that will hold them accountable for every piece of action. But what in the agenda of everyone who will run for the highest and the second highest office, I would like to see the mainstreaming of sustainability, the mainstreaming of the climate agenda, because that is the only way we can actually recover from this pandemic, to bring about culture-based rural livelihoods, to be bring about healthcare up to the barangay level, to bring about an educational system that will respond to even possible pandemics in the future.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. Congresswoman Lauren Legarda, nice to see you again. Continue to keep safe. Take care.
Thank you, Carmina.